please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
So it was record tumbling day on Dalal Street yesterday, and we've been in that kind of a zone for a while now, haven't we? So the last close, you saw both those indices, 36,000 plus on the Sensex and 11,000 plus on the Nifty. In fact, the Nifty now taking aim at 11,100 so quickly. It's also expiry week. We're just one day away from that event. So what should we watch out for today? What's the setup looking like? We have Naveen Shetty joining in with his synopsis. Naveen. Good morning,
Surbhi. Good morning. So, yeah, ahead of the next big trigger is expiry. But just look at how the trade panned out yesterday. It's clearly all positive signals. We had we broke record highs and reached that 11,000 mark on the Nifty, 36,000 mark on the Sensex. In fact, if you see both the major indices, the other ones like the Bank Nifty as well as Midcap, they were moving in tandem, both in the positive terrain itself. Also, if you see going ahead post the market, we got the fund flows also, institutional fund flows. Both were again positive. If you see the cash market data, FI has bought close to 1,300 crore and the DI has also bought close to 170 crore on the stock futures also, they were buying from the FIIs of close to 9,970 crores. So going ahead today, we are going into the trade with all with maximum amount of positive cues that we can see. On the other hand, if you see the levels, 11,000 now seems to be like a base for the Nifty, given the fact that the maximum put addition happened at the 11,000 levels at around 31 lakh shares. Remember, the premium over here has also squeezed from those 60 rupees level to 22. But keep an eye that tomorrow is the expiry day. On the other hand, one more key point to watch out will be the PCR at around 189 versus 1.73. This is a record high, but again, one more point to remember is that tomorrow will be your expiry, FNO expiry. On the other hand, global markets, they seems to be lackluster. European indices, not much to talk about. The DAX ended up 0.6%, but CAC was also flattish. Dow Jones was also ended on a flattish note, and SGX Nifty indicates a flattish opening for our market itself. But overall, medium term seems to be positive for the markets. Back to you.
All right. Medium term seems to be positive for the markets, but ultra near term, I mean, today, what are the stocks that you're watching out for?
So quite a few mid-cap stocks, small cap to mid-cap stocks will be in focus. Before I begin with results, there are a few stocks like ECLERX. ECLERX has announced a buyback of almost 3% to 4% is the acceptance ratio at the price of 2,000 rupees. On the other hand, ALEMBIC has also announced a buyback. The company is expected to buy back close to 10 crore shares at around 80 rupees. Apart from this, a lot of fundraising is happening given the fact that the markets are zooming. So you have SANGHI Industries, which is approved an issue of around 129 rupees. That is a CMP for the stock. On the other hand, Majesco, the floor price for the QIP is fixed at around 532 rupees. Apart from this, some expansion coming in for Guinness. But this is one stock we don't talk much, but has done quite well. Leases manufacturing facility for the production of craft paper. So some capex over there. Wipro is also one stock which will be in focus given the fact that they have won an award. Apart from this, a lot of stocks will be buzzing on the back of results that they posted yesterday post-market. Shimaru Entertainment, what a run that stock has seen, almost 35% in the last two sessions. And clearly, the numbers also have been showing that revenue growth of 17%, but operating margins have also been maintained at the higher end of around 27%. On the other hand, Swaraj Engines also have been posting good set of numbers. The EPS over there has jumped close to 15% at around 13 rupees, and the PAT has jumped 12%. Syngene International, again, a subsidiary of Biocon, that has posted good set of numbers. Revenue up 17%. Operating margins have also remained stable around those 33% levels. Rapphila International, last quarter was good for this company, but this quarter seems to be not that great, given the fact that the margins have been down close to 250 basis points at 9.5%. NK Wheels, again, a company in the aluminium casting business, margins have zoomed to 8.8%. Remember, this is a jump of close to 200 basis points for the stock. On the other hand, Nucleus Software, good set of numbers continue for the third or fourth quarter. In fact, EBITDA has jumped close to 32% and margins 200 basis points. Wabco International, again, the streak of these auto ancillary companies in terms of good results seems to be continuing. Margins are almost steady, but the revenue is up close to 33% for Wabco India. Back to you.